How in the hell are the Packers gonna lose like that? You get... You return the kickoff 70 yards. You get down to the 1 yard line. You have 4 downs to score, and you end up taking a giant shit right in the middle of the field, and you end up losing the game to the Steelers. Come on, man. Like, what in the name of Arnold Schwarzenegger's inebriated, upside-down, wine-corking bottle set? I think I just got diabetes. I got diabetes. I really did. Anywho, welcome back. Let's play some more Gran Turismo 2. I'm in a giant state of just unbridled rage. But I have things to talk about. Because outside of me hating life because, you know, the Packers lost, but the Seahawks lost, which was great, we have some information, or I have information to tell you to your face through a computer screen that you can listen to. So, at the merit of one of my awesome viewers that goes by the name of SeaFergMusic1, he told me some great info that's going to be very helpful going forward here, and it applies 130% to the situation here, and for some reason, unbeknownst to me, my controller is not working, so hold on a second, and I'll be right back as I fix this problem. Hold on. Alright, so I'm back. It was actually really stupid, by the way. It totally wasn't even anything with my controller. I was just dumb enough to not have put the focus on this window for the emulator, so that's 100% my own fault. So I should, So here's the deal. Here's the information that's going to be super important. There's actually a couple pieces of info here. Good old SeaFerg1 shed some light on the old situation here. So the reason why we've been having problems finding the Subaru SVX, I'm actually going to get into a car because you'll understand in a minute. We're going to get into the old Dyson Sylvia, which has gotten me out of issues numerous times. It kind of like got me through like Gran Turismo puberty, in a sense, because I did a lot of races with it. It doesn't really make any sense, but I'm sticking with it anyways. So the reason why the SVX doesn't show up in here is because of the fact that the used car lineup is randomly generated. And what I mean by that is the little days counter down there on the bottom, every time you do something, like a race or whatever, it'll advance 1 day. And they'll change the used car lineup every so often number of days, whatever. So I think it's like every 10 days. I'm not sure. I would imagine that would probably be a number that makes sense. So what he told me is, if you were to just, you know, go into a race like this, I'll show you exactly what he told me. So let's say you go into a race like the Sylvia Challenge, which is perfect. That's why I picked the Dyson Sylvia. It's close by to Subaru, because we're probably going to have to do this a couple of times. You go into the race. You don't actually have to do the race. You can just exit out of it, which is awesome, because I really would not want to have to do this a whole bunch of times. So you go out of the race, and look at that. Your counter advances 1 day. So with that knowledge, and you go back there, you'll be like, oh, let's go have a look at the old used car lineup, blah, 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 blah. See, it's still the same, but once we get to, I'll show you what happens a couple more times here. So we'll get to, God damn it. We'll go to day 290 on the old counter here. Now, I'm not going to show this a billion times because I don't know how long it's going to take to have this thing show up magically. It would be super awesome if it did it right here at 290, because that would be hilarious. Now, I know it's not going to show up there, so we're going to do this one more time. I do remember somebody telling me, or I read somewhere while I was trying to find the answers, that the used car lot does refresh this on a number like that. So let's just go in here real quick, blah-blah-blah. Okay, so now we're at 290. Let's go have a look-see at the old used car lineup, shall we? Okay, see, it's a little bit different. That Subaru 360 that was up at the top is now not there. So it shows that in another probably 10 days or so, they will refresh it again, which I'm really hoping that the SVX will be there. But because of how long that's going to take, I'm not going to show it on camera. So give me a few seconds. It's actually going to take no time at all, because I'm just going to cut that out, and then you'll be right here. So I'm going to take a few minutes to advance it up 10 days, and then I'll be right back. So hold on a second, guys. All right, I'm back again. That actually didn't take nearly as long as I thought it would. So let's see if the theory stands up. We're a little 10 days later down the old, right down the old Jin Kazama here. So let's check the used car lot. Oh my god, look at that. There she is! Whee! All right, let's buy one of these right now. All that work just for this thing. Doesn't even look very good. It's a weird looking car. But you know what? I don't even care. So here's the other piece of information that I will tell you, that he told me, that I am relaying to you, is because of the fact that there are some other things involved in order to get us to the actual, like, 100% in this game or whatever the hell it is, which part of that being getting gold medals in all of the license tests, those actually count towards your percentage of game completion. So I can tell you one thing right now. I will not even begin telling you that I am going to get gold in all those license tests. It's not going to happen. I absolutely refuse to do that, because that will take me forever to do. Because I only got gold in just a few of them, most of those being like the off-roading, you know, dirt stuff. So if you think for one second that I'm going to do that, I'm not going to. So that kind of, I know that you guys are like, whoa, but you're not going to get the 100%. And I'm like, well, I know, but that's okay, because I've already done fucking like 140 videos of this. So I think that we'll be okay. I don't think that anybody's feelings are going to be hurt if I don't get the full 100%. But also at the same time, thank you, Seaferg Music 1, for giving me the information on this SVX, because I would have probably blown my own brains out all over the steaming cold pavement. Yes, steaming cold pavement. That's a new type of thing. From not being able to figure this out, also not knowing about that whole license thing with the golds making a higher percentage in there. So it's a good thing to know. But after I complete this little series of races, what I am going to do is I'm going to go back and just make sure that I got all the races done, like all the ones that I can do. I'm still going to do the event generator too, because I'm not sure if that contributes to it or not. So this is right here as we are viewing it in its live feed for me, not for you. This is one of the last sets of races we're going to be doing right now. It's crazy to think about, huh? But it's happening that way. So drink it all in, you know? So I have something to talk about today. And it was something that was really funny when it first happened. You guys may not think it's funny at all, actually. But for me, I was having a really, really weird conversation with my coworker Blake yesterday at work. Because I have to work Saturdays now, which is a total buzzkill. I totally hate it. But it's all right. So we're working, and he was talking something about like this girl that he knew that he saw randomly on the street the other day, and like she apparently had moved away and she like got admitted to like an Ivy League school or something like that. He's like, so apparently she's like super smart. I didn't even know that. Like, she never really gave off the vibe that she was. She's like, but yeah, she's like going to some sort of Ivy League school. He's like, I don't know really which one though. He's like, I don't really know all the Ivy League schools that well. It's like, it wasn't like, it's like, I want to say it was like Stanford. I was like, well, first of all, Stanford's not an Ivy League school. I mean, they kind of are, but not like officially. They're basically like the West Coast version of an Ivy League school. And so then we were like, we got into some sort of conversation. Don't even know how it even started. It's like, I wonder, like, because of the fact that they're so smart over there, like, I wonder if like their language classes, like any sort of like, you know, language class they do. Like, I wonder if they just, like, do the entire class talking, like, the professor talks to their students in binary code. And, like, that's just all the talking done in language classes in binary code. And he's like, for those of you that don't know what binary code is, it's, like, you know, all language done in, like, it's computer language done in zeros and ones. It's, like, programming stuff. And he's like, I don't know. He's like, can't you imagine that'd be really weird? like super awkward for a person that walked into that class like as a freshman and didn't know that was how they conducted business in there. So you walk in and the you walk into the class and you go and sit down and the professor's just like 0110 0010 and everybody sits down 0110 10100110. I know there's going to be somebody that's going to try to decode all this shit that knows binary code and be like, that doesn't even mean anything to do. Like, I don't care. Back to it. But then it starts getting, like, kind of out of hand. They, like, start, like, going over homework. And then, you know, one of the students starts, like, getting into an argument. And it starts heating up a little bit, which makes the situation all the more awkward. He's like, 0110 00 110 0110. But 0110 0110 0 0 1 1 0 0 1 1 0 1 1 0 0 1 1 1 1 0 0 1 0. And then he's just like 0 1 0 1 0 1 fucking 1 0 1. Like, yes, of course he'd have to throw a regular actual swear word in there with it, because that's how it would go, because I said so. But imagine how awkward that would be for somebody if in the event that they were actually talking like that. First of all, let's just get this out of the way. If they were talking in actual binary code, they'd have to say that way longer, because, like, if you're actually trying to spell things out with binary code, it takes a lot. So that, like, wouldn't even be a conversation that would even happen. It'd be like when they do, like, silent film things, like Japanese silent film things, where their mouths just move, like, really, really long, for, like, really long periods of time, and all you get out of it is, like, two words. That's what it would be like, essentially. Alright, let's, ooh. Oh, they all look dumb. Let's take the blue one, at least. I'll take the blue one. I will take the bullet in this one. So yeah, it was a weird, pretty stupid conversation we were having. We have a lot of dumb conversations like that at work, but it was just something to, like, think about, like, man, like, how awesome would that be to go into a class, like, knowing that they were going to do that, but at the same time, like, you don't know they're going to do that. Like, the other people in there have no idea what's going to happen. Just, like, seeing the looks on their faces, like, oh my god, I think I'm in the wrong class! I didn't realize they'd be talking in robot language. Oh, dude, they're doing this race? Oh, no. That's not what I need to see right now. 0110101. Oh, dude, my nose is burning right now. What the hell for? Why am I in such pain? Oh, God, these... Whoa! Whoa! That was weird. He, like, absorbed my car into his car a little bit, kind of like a sponge, and it was weird. And every single one of these cars is faster than me, like, significantly for some reason. It's weird. Luckily I can make up just a little bit. Oh gosh. Oh, I almost pulled off an amazing little maneuver there. Didn't quite work out though. So yeah, dude, it's crazy to think that we're, like, almost ready to pull the series to a close. I almost thought it would never happen. I thought I'd be trapped in the Gran Turismo 2 purgatory stage of hell for, like, the rest of my life. But we're almost there. I mean, the Subaru SVX. It's, like, one of the last things to do. Oh my god, these guys need to get out of the way. No. Hey, look at that turn. What a turn. What a shovel pass! I just really hope I don't have to be stuck doing this race over and over again. I don't think I'll have to, though, because I'm going to do one of these! I am a douchebag! The people voted in, and they decided that they want 4 more years of douchebag! Okay, here we go. Oh, my God. Awesome boss. Awesome boss dick right here. You know what I'm really going to have to do, like, after I get done with this video, probably, so I'll have to start working on that godforsaken year-in-review thing again, because, I mean, luckily, I don't think I really did as many series this year as I did last year, I did a lot of them last year. I don't think I really did quite as many games this year, mainly because I was doing this, which was a very, very long chunk of time. But it'll be something. The hard part is going to be like going back through all of those videos to find the ones that are highlight worthy, amongst other things. Oh no, you don't. You think you're going to pull a little quick one on me? I don't think so. Because the straightaways are where I make all my money. It's just not going to work out that way for you. Yeah, look at that. Look at that little series of turns, you little jackalope pies. Not even happening today. I won't allow it. Oh no, but he's going to try to force feed his way in here, and I won't let him. It's just not going to happen. Just got to make sure I do some clean turns here. That's the most important part, because there's a couple areas up here that I could potentially squander this thing away like the Packers. Oh no, see? Just like that. That's exactly what I'm talking about. But I won't let it happen. There we go. Whew! Boy, that was close. I actually slowed down more on that on purpose because of the fact that I was afraid that the car that was kind of like trying to overtake my spot was going to kind of go behind me. So I actually had to make sure that I ended up hitting him. Wow, the Eagles are totally killing the Bears right now. Chip Kelly at his finest, my friends. He is laying the wood. Oh no, oh no. No, I took that turn really wide. No, no. I ruined it. No. Oh, I blew it. I totally blew it. Why? Damn it. Of course, the one time that I didn't need to worry, or that I needed to worry about something, I didn't. Ugh. Damn it. It's alright. I'm going to do this race. Like, I'm going to do it. In this video, I will have this done and out of the way, just because I said so. So, here we go. Please don't give me a stupid race again. Give me something that I can do. Seattle short. That's what I wanted. I wanted something that was quick and easy to the point, not something that it's all full of windy bullshit. Alright. And then I can win another race and rub it into the face of Seattle all over again because of the fact they already lost today. How are you gonna lose to the Arizona Cardinals with Carson Palmer? The best part is that they forced four interceptions and still only scored 10 points. Like, how pathetic is that? I mean, of course, I don't really have a lot of room to talk because my own team lost today, but at the same time, I have room to talk because so many Seattle fans that I know, they're like, oh, well, yeah, we're totally invincible at home. We're the best team in the history of mankind. It's like, well, you know what? Guess what? You guys played at home. You forced a bunch of turnovers and you only scored 10 points, so why don't you go put that one in your pipe and smoke it, you little jizz hats. Alrighty, here we go. I'm gonna get right on down here. Not even gonna give these guys an opportunity to slide their way in here and overtake me. Just can't let it happen. Not today. Not after what I've been through. Not after the things I've seen. That's a pass interference, maybe not. No, it's what happens when I start looking at the TV. Things like this happen. God damn. Okay, I need to not look at my TV unless I want to do one of these damn things again. Don't let the world get the best of you, Adam. You just can't let it happen. The outside world is conspiring against you. Satan is trying to make his way into your life to ruin your racing odds, and you just have to tell him no. No, I'm on the pill. Even though the pill would not have anything to do with that, but it does. Come on, baby. Here we go. Yeah, I'm in the zone now. I am committed in this relationship right now today. Dude, the handling for this car is so good. Like, I mean, in a couple of areas you guys wouldn't really have known because I almost intentionally did something stupid. But the handling for this car is really good. Like, it almost seems like it's cheating. Like, it's on rails or something, but it's just, like, abnormally really good. Okay, here we go. Don't mess it up. Don't mess it up. Here we go to save the day. Cut him off and make him lose. Yay! Oh, look at me. I'm Jay Cutler. Oh, actually, that would have hurt. Okay. How awesome. We have won! We have defeated the Subaru Alcyon Challenge, or Alky 1, or whatever it is. Still don't know the proper pronunciation for that, but it's just going to go with whatever I say it's going to be. I'm going to have a text message, and it's not really important. Yeehaw. Let's check our percentage of winning now, my friends. We're at a whopping 96.41%, which leaves but one challenge. The one challenge that we have remaining in this game, because I'm not doing all the gold stuff and the license testing, we have these! The event generator. Generator Rex. And guess what? After that's done, we're done with the entire game! Alright! Yeah! This, my friends, has been your host, AMF1534, saying thank you guys for watching. Thanks again to Seaferg Music 1 for all the great info and tips in this particular situation. And I'm going to go get something to eat, and I will see you guys next time. So take care. Have a good one. Bye.